According to the World Health Organization, antibiotic resistance is one of the biggest current threats to global health. Infectious disease researcher Dr. Ravina Kullar is with us to discuss that subject. So, what can you tell us about these nightmare bacteria? Should we really be concerned?
Yep, so first of all, I want to address your first question about these nightmare bacteria. This is referring to carbapenem-resistant Enterobacteriaceae. Try saying that three times. Or CRE, and the carbapenem refers to the class of antibiotics that the bacteria Enterobacteriaceae do not respond to because they've developed resistance. These bacteria typically cause infections such as pneumonia, bloodstream infections, and urinary tract infections. Why they're called nightmare is because there are very little antibiotics that we currently have in place to even work against them. And these resistant genes can actually jump to other bacteria, and the risk for transmission can be quite high.
So why has this happened?
Yeah.
What has caused this true
resistance issue? The primary reason why, short answer, is the inappropriate overuse of antibiotics. Antibiotics are the only drug where every time each one of us uses it, it becomes less and less effective, not only in us, but in those that have not even been exposed to the drug. Bacteria have been in existence for over 3.5 billion years. And it only takes them minutes to learn how to multiply and mutate to work against those antibiotics. What I see coming is that we're gonna come to a time where antibiotics will not be able to cure simple infections.
So what will we do?
Number one, stop buying meat raised with antibiotics. Almost 80% of all antibiotics in the United States are not taken by people, but they're used in animals, primarily as growth promoters.
That's a staggering number.
Yeah. And I think in terms of the scale of this, I read one statistic that 2 million infections were caused by bacteria with such resistant genes last year, and 23,000 people in the U.S. died from these types of resistant infections.
Right, so that's actually just in the U.S. I'm gonna give you a global perspective. Currently, over 700,000 people have died per year worldwide, and this number is projected to exceed 10 million people per year worldwide by the year 2050.
So, for people at home, just remember this conversation. Remember that we want you to get better as physicians. So it's not that we're withholding treatment, it's just that antibiotics cannot, they literally cannot help your virus. And that's why we don't want to prescribe them, because they cannot help you. They will only harm you, because if you need that antibiotic in the future, it may not be effective for
you. Exactly, yep. Yep, every time that our body gets hit with an antibiotic, the bacteria are already learning how to really develop resistance. So when you need it, it's not gonna be available and effective. And as healthcare providers, we're responsible as well. Every time a patient comes in and you're thinking about writing a prescription for an antibiotic, think again.
Really good points, really interesting perspective. Thank you for coming, Dr. Kullar.
Yeah.
I'll make us think a little bit.